So what goes into a regular expression? Well, we saw one example where the star was a special character, and where, for example, a star represents a, and so on, as well as the empty string, because it could be zero occurrences of a. So let's make a list of the special characters, examples of their use, and what they match. So we've seen the asterisk. Another special character is the question mark. So a question mark matches either the empty string or the single string a and nothing else. So it means an optional occurrence of whatever comes before. In this case, an a. Could be a b, a c, whatever. Another special character is the dot or period, and that stands by itself. It doesn't have a two-character sequence. And so, for example, a dot can match the character A or the character B or C or 7 or exclamation point or any other single character. But it doesn't match the empty string and it doesn't match a multiple character string. We're almost done. There's only two more special characters in this subset of regular expressions that I want to talk about. Languages like Python have very complicated patterns that they can match against for regular expressions. Some of them go beyond regular to irregular expressions. But we're going to talk about a specific subset that we can write a program for to do regular expression matching. And it's only going to have 5 special characters. So these 3, then the up arrow, again, is a character that's by itself, not a two-character sequence. So the up arrow by itself matches only right at the beginning of the line, or that is the beginning of the text that we're matching against. And so it's not much use by itself, but in conjunction with another character, it can limit the match to the beginning. So, for example, up arrow B matches against any string that starts with a B, like BA or BB or anything else where B is the first character, but it doesn't match something where the B is in the middle, like ABC. Whereas B by itself would match against ABC in the middle. And finally, dollar sign is the convention for matching at the end. So A dollar sign matches BA, but doesn't match, say, AB or anything else where the A isn't at the end. So let's correctly strike these out to say that these are not matches for these two patterns. Okay, so that's it. These are the 5 special characters. What else goes into a regular expression? Well, the empty string, and the only example of the empty string is the empty string. And what does that match? Only the empty string. Then any character that's not one of these 5, like an A, that matches exactly the character itself. A matches A, B matches B, and so on. And finally, any concatenation of 2 regular expressions matches those 2, one followed by another. So BA, that matches BA, but doesn't match other sequences like AA or BB. Okay, so that's my language for regular expressions. 5 special characters, empty character, 1 character, or 2 regular expressions concatenated to each other.